the local governments really kept this on everyone's radar so I could be effective in Ottawa. And then the local and regional governments spread the word and identified who in the community could actually take hold of this, because we can't do it without the expertise here. So I'd like to thank Bruce Milne for making this a priority for the scarce resources that Seashelt has, and actually putting John Devison, Public Works Supervisor, on the job. So then John went to the extraordinary amount of work of filling out these forms, analyzing boats, working with Lucy on our team, to be told he had the best application they'd ever seen in Ottawa, and then to be told he sent it to the wrong place. So we figured that out, and that's what I mean by patience and hanging in there. But thank you, because we're learning too how to make this work. Similarly, but taking a different approach, the SCRD worked with the Pender Harbor Advisory Council. That's the entity there. And two women, Penny Harrison and Eliza Kinley, did the work in Pender Harbor. Today, Ian Wynn is working with the Howe Sound Community Association to address boats there. So this is truly a grassroots, all the way from that to Ottawa effort. Our community has led when it comes to small boats. And so today it's a real pleasure to announce that Seashelt is being awarded $70,000 to do the work to assess 14 vessels, and Pender Harbor is being awarded $10,000. So it's the early days. Money will continue to flow because we know that 14 boats in Seashelt and two in Pender Harbor is just scratching the surface. But it's a strong beginning. So please let me know how it all works so we can continue to refine this. And congratulations. In 2 years, we've gone from nothing to some really substantive work to protect the environment, to make waterways safer and cleaner, to deal with hazards to navigation, and I just couldn't be more thrilled to be working with you. Thank you.